गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 10th. वील स्टडी अबाउट मेटालिक करेक्टर्स एंड डिफरेंट फैक्टर्स. फॉर मेटालिक करेक्टर्स वील ऑल्सो सी इट्स वेरिएशन ऑफ मेटालिक करेक्टर्स इन द पीरियोडिक टेबल. सो एज यू नो अबाउट द मेटल्स दैट मेटल्स हैव द टेंडेंसी टू लूज द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स फ्रॉम देयर आउटर मोस्ट ऑर्बिट एंड वेन एवर दे आर लूजिंग द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स द एनर्जी इज बीन रिक्वायर्ड सो दैट the electrons can be removed, right? We know about the metals that metals now we know that the metals, if I write down over here, I am representing metal with M, and this particular M is been it's been indicating about the atom of an metal. And what happens, we remove one electron from it, then in this particular case it's acquire a positive charge. You know that metals always lose electron and they always acquire a positive charge. When this particular electron is been removed from the outermost orbit of an atom, the energy is been required over here, that we have already discussed, or energy is been required or supplied. That particular energy we known as ionization potential or ionization energy. We also know that we have discussed earlier that metals have the tendency to lose electrons, like one or more than one. How much they can lose? One electrons, two, and maximum three electrons they can remove. And there are some certain special cases where they are removing four electrons also, but mainly the metal have the tendency to lose the electrons, and that is one, two, or three electrons from their outermost orbit. Over here you can understand that we have different examples for it, like Na acquiring plus charge, it means it will lose one electron, that's why it is holding a positive charge. If we talk about Ca plus 2, so over here how many electrons is being lost by this particular atom to convert itself to a cation, that is 2 electrons. Aluminium is there, it's acquire a positive 3 charge, so it is losing 3 electrons from its outermost orbit. You know it very well. If you see their electronic configuration, it's like that, 2, 8, 1. Over here it's 2, 8, 8, 2. Over here you can say 2, 8, 3. So you can see the outermost orbits. Over here it's one electrons, over here it's two electrons, over here it's three electrons. So that's why if we lose one electron, it will acquire a positive one charge. 2 plus 2, then 3 electrons been removed from the outermost orbit, it's plus 3. So every time you are seeing that every time when you are removing electrons, energy is been required, and that energy is known as ionization energy. This we have discussed earlier also. Now we'll see that also, that about the factors for the that are responsible for the metallic characters in metals. That is, first is atomic radius or atomic size, and second is ionization potential, right? So over here what happens, ki when you talk, when you see these two factors, and we have discussed these factors earlier also, like when the atomic size is more or it's been large, then ionization potential is less. You need very less amount of energy to remove the electron from its outermost orbit. Let's make a diagram and we can understand this particular fact. Now you can see I have made the structure for the atom of sodium. It's a sodium atom, and you know that you want to remove the electron from its outermost orbit. So over here you need an energy to remove this particular electron, and that energy is known as ionization potential. Now what we say, that why the atomic radius is important for it, and what is the concept of ionization potential. Now over here this particular atom, you know the orbit is more. Even if you make it like this with some other atom, say I am making it with oxygen, right? You know the tendency of oxygen, it is a non-metal, it will accept the electron, it will not remove the electron from its outermost orbit. So over here you can see the atomic size is more comparison to this one, and when the atomic size is more, this particular electrons will move off from its outermost orbit. When it is moving out, for that you need certain energy, that is ionization potential, and this ionization potential will be less comparison to this particular atom. Why this is happening? also, because you once again I am repeating that the pull that has been exerted by the nucleus on the electrons that are present on the outermost orbit is what, it's less, it's been now less because the atomic size has been increased, and for that this particular attraction is less, it's holding the electrons with a lesser extent, right, comparison to other atom. And over here you need less amount of energy to remove that particular electron from its outermost orbit. So that's why the distance is more or atomic size is more, the ionization potential will always decreases, and this is one of the important factor which help you to explain about the metallic characters in groups as well as in periods. Now we also come across with many things about our this character, that larger we came across one thing, that more the atomic size or more the atomic radii, low will your ionization potential. By this you can see, more the atomic radii, low will be your ionization potential. Now once a particular atom is having a low ionization potential, its tendency of losing the electrons is also increases, right? So again I am telling you, more the atomic size, less will be its ionization potential, and that particular point, if you want to remove the electron, the tendency to lose electron by that particular atom is always increases, like. So that's why what happens here, because of these two factors, these particular metals are good reducing agents, right? They are a good reducing agents, and they have a greater tendency to lose electron, and because of that you can see they can easily form the particular cations also. Now I've written this thing of a period, and in this all the elements I've written, and by looking the electronic configuration, now you can judge that this particular elements, these elements are coming in the third period because they have three shells, and you can see over here 1, 2, 3, every time three shells, it means they are coming in the third shell. And I have written the nature of these elements, like these are metals, this is a metalloid, from here it's a non-metals, my space was less so I put it like this. This is also, Cr is also a non-metal, and argon is a noble gas. So this way we can understand that this particular period contains so different types of you can say elements, and we'll see that how it varies or your metallic characters varies in the period. Now you can see from the period and whatever I have written over here, that when you move from left to right in a period, this metallic character is decreasing. How come? Why this is happening? Because you can understand that initially the elements are metals, and after that these metals are changing to metalloids and non-metals, and in the end you are getting a noble gases. So it means the metallic characters is decreasing. So if I am saying that the metallic character is decreasing, then what is the, you can say, why this is happening, that you have to analyze. Now once again we are focusing on the two factors. Now you can see I have made two atoms, and it's from your period which I have mentioned earlier, and this is the atom metal that is of sodium, and this is the first atom you can see, and this is the non-metal chlorine, and this is the second last you can say non-metal that was placed in your third period. Now please don't think that I am making bond formation, but I just want to tell you that how the particular factors are there in these two cases. Now once again we are seeing, just see over here, if it is the first member of the period and its atomic size is more, you know the atomic size decreases when you move across the period, right? So this was the first element, its atomic size is more, comparison to this one it is less. So that particular point, if your atomic size is more, if you want to remove the electrons from the outermost orbit, you need less amount of ionization energy over here, right? That is the point. So you need a less amount of ionization energy in this particular case of atom. But if this is your case, when your atomic size is less, I have made the diagram in small size also, and you know why the atomic size is less over here, because we have already discussed in the concept of atomic size that your nuclear charge is also increasing and your atomic size is less because the number of shells are less. So because of it, your size was small. These two factors we have discussed why this happens. So over here, your atomic size is small. Because of it, if you want to remove the electrons from its outermost orbit, you need large amount of energy of ionization over here. You need large amount of ionization potential energy in this case when you want to remove the electrons from its outermost orbit. So over here, more the atomic size, less amount of energy is required to remove the electron. But over here, if the energy, the atomic size is less, you need large amount of energy, that is your ionization energy, to remove the electrons. Initially, the point is that it's a non-metal. They don't have the tendency to lose electron. But still, if you want to remove, it means you are doing against the will of this particular atom. It's don't have a tendency to, you can say, remove the electrons, but they are, you have to add the electron over here, but still you are doing so you over here you need large amount of ionization energy, right? So what happened, let's come back to our concept. So now we can see that this particular, now it is clear to you, there is more atomic size, so you need less amount of ionization energy to remove this particular electrons from its outermost orbit. Over here, the atomic size was less, so you need large amount of ionization energy to remove from its outermost orbit, right? So remove the electron from its outermost orbit in this case, right? So what happened, what you get the conclusion that atomic size is, or atomic radius is decreasing when we move across the period. So in that particular case, the ionization potential is increasing, right? We have already seen why it is increasing over here and why it is ionization potential is less. So what happens, the point is that your atomic size is been over here, it's been decreasing. So your ionization potential is increasing. So what we get in conclusion regarding it, that atomic size is decreasing or decreases when we move across a period from left to right. So because of it, your ionization potential is increases. So in period when we move from left to right, and in that particular case the non-metallic characters always decreases, right? So metallic characters is decreases. This is our conclusion, and we have discussed it in a very broader form in periods. Now we'll focus that how this particular metallic character varies in your group, and I have written a group over here, and by looking it you can understand it is a 14 group that is been there, and this particular 14 group is been, you can see that I have written all the elements and their electronic configuration also I have written, and I have also written that what type of natures these particular elements are. This is a non-metal, it is a, these two are metalloids, it is a metal. So we'll see these two factors again the atomic radii and ionization potential, how they are affecting in the group, and what result we can get for the metallic characters in the group, right? So we'll study. Now I made the structure for it, and over here you can see that I made the two structures for that atom, and this side you can understand the electronic configurations I have written, and you can easily judge over here the electronic configurations and the structures, and by looking the diagram over here the atomic size is less. So less the atomic size, more will be your ionization potential, means if you want to remove the electrons from its outermost orbit, you need large amount of energy over here. So you need large amount of energy to remove the electrons from its outermost orbit over here. But if you see this, over here the atomic size is more, and the distance is more, so you need less amount of energy to remove the electrons from its outermost orbit. So more the ionization, more the atomic size, more less will be your ionization potential. Over here, less will be the atomic size, more will be your ionization potential. Now by looking these two diagrams, you can easily judge that more your ionization potential was there over here, and because of it, what is happening, it's been your atomic size was over here less. So in that particular case, it is not showing your metallic characters, because we have already seen earlier that for metallic characters or a particular atom showing a metallic character, it will show low ionization potential. Over here, who is having the low ionization potential? This atom, because its atomic size is more. So more the atomic size, less will be your ionization potential value, and more metallic character it will show. So this will be more metallic comparison to this thing. Now we can draw certain conclusions over here. Now I have written the conclusion over here: atomic size increases, ionization potential decreases, metallic characters will also increases when we move across a group. So these conclusions you can across the group, and you move from down to bottom, the metallic characters increases.